Now to Dr. Ashton. That's the info for our viewers. Here's a question, Doc. Is it safe to attend an indoor group fitness class if I'm vaccinated and wearing a mask? Or should I keep working out at home until boosters are available? What do you do with that?
This is a tricky question because there really is no official scientific guidance for this. The story behind this question is really how this individual is comfortable or not comfortable with risk and stratifying risk and fear of the unknown. And remember, you know, when we leave our homes to go anywhere, we could get into a car accident. There are other things that can happen. It's not just COVID. Right now, again, the CDC is considering people who have been fully vaccinated, two doses of Pfizer or Moderna, or a single dose of Johnson & Johnson. The boosters are not changing that. If you want to wear a mask indoors, which is what the CDC is recommending now in any area where COVID transmission is high, which would include an indoor fitness facility, that's really all you can do. If you're not comfortable with that, then sure, exercise outside or exercise at home.
Yeah. No, and we've got another question about cancer screening during this pandemic. Are pelvic sonograms a good way to screen for ovarian cancer?
So this is a great question. And for women's health, it is really important that people understand there is no accepted screening test for ovarian cancer. However, and here's the big however, pelvic sonograms or ultrasounds can be very useful. But it's not just the sonogram, it's who is interpreting the sonogram, because what you don't want is any little benign cyst, which the majority of findings are, to trigger surgery, which is worse than anything else that you would detect. In 16 years of practice, I have never detected ovarian cancer doing a regular ultrasound. I've detected other things, but not ovarian cancer. So again, if you're having symptoms, bloating, pelvic pain, increase in urination, talk to your gynecologist. Make sure those symptoms are evaluated and assessed. Usually it's with blood tests and ultrasounds, but there is not yet a good screening test for this type of cancer.
All right, Dr. Jen, we appreciate
it.
You can submit your questions to Dr. Jen on her Instagram at Dr. J. Ashton.
Well, hey there, GMA fans. Robin Roberts here. Thanks for checking out our YouTube channel. Lots of great stuff here. So go on, click the subscribe button right over here to get more of awesome videos and content from GMA every day, anytime. We thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the morning on GMA.